Hey, HG Kids Live, Pastor Campbell here. Happy Easter. I'm excited to be with you guys. Romans 8:1 says that there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. So we know that if we are following after Jesus, we are in Christ. We are a new creation. So today I want us to focus on the crucified Christ and his resurrection. All right, see you guys later.
Day in history, death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. Yeah, he's alive. Stand in that place, free at last, meeting face to face. I am yours, Jesus, you are mine. The endless joy and perfect peace, earthly pain finally we'll see. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. Is the flow that
Like I said, happy Easter, everyone. Today we're going to look at Christ crucified and his resurrection. We know that Christ was victorious in life and over the grave because he rose 3 days later, and we can now stand in victory today. But before we get to the story, I want to ask you guys a question. Do you know what the word identity means? Yeah, maybe you've heard of it. Maybe kind of like people have secret identities, like Superman's secret identity is the fact that he is who? Clark Kent, that's right. And Spider-Man is who? Peter Parker, Black Panther, is who? That's right, he's T'Challa. Okay, let me think of one more. What about Batman? Who's Batman? Yeah, he's Bruce Wayne. All of these people have an identity. They've got a secret identity. But today I'm going to talk about something a little bit different. I'm going to talk about finding our identity in Christ. You see, if we find our identity in Christ and not in the world, then that's exactly what we're supposed to do. If you were to say the most important thing about me is that God loves me and that Christ died on the cross for me, you're getting there. That's exactly right. That's what we are hoping for, that you would choose to find your identity in Christ and in nothing else. When maybe you don't succeed in something, you would go back and you would say, my identity is in Christ. If you were to have your biggest success, the best things happening, you would still say, my identity is in Christ. Nothing is better than him. And today we're going to look at why Christ is the center of our identity and why Christ is at the center of the gospel. His works, his deeds, and his love for us on the cross. So I want us to think back. Jesus was back in the Garden at Gethsemane, and he was going to allow these people to take him. He had just been betrayed by one of his disciples, Judas, and he went with his betrayer. He went with the people who were arresting him because they hated him, because people have always been in rebellion against God. So they're here even against God's plans to seek and save the lost. So what happened was that the religious people took Jesus and they said, you have been saying all of these things. Are you the Son of God? And Jesus said, yes. He told them the truth, but they did not believe him. So the next day, they took Jesus before the governor, before this man named Pilate. And Pilate couldn't find anything wrong with him. But Pilate said, are you the king of the Jews? And Jesus said, yes, I am. Pilate didn't want to kill Jesus. He thought that Jesus was a good man, someone who is innocent of his crimes. And we know that he is. Jesus is the Son of God. He is the King of the world. But, you see, Pilate turned him over to the people. Pilate said, what am I going to do with Jesus? What is his punishment? And the people cried out, crucify him. Now, crucify, when people are crucified, it's not an easy death. This is some of the most gruesome ways that people could die. They beat him first, and then they took him up onto a hill for him to die on. They put robes on him to mock him. They put a crown of thorns on him and a sign that said, Jesus, King of the Jews, all to make fun of Jesus. He took all of this mocking for me and for you so that he could die a sinner's death, a terrible death for us in our place if we follow after him. When he was on the cross, after they put him up next to two criminals who were dying there with him, you see, Jesus looked up into heaven and he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? Because God was punishing him in our place. And the sky grew dark. And Jesus lifted his spirit up to God. And there was earthquakes. And there was people coming out of their tombs. They had been resurrected. And the curtain of the temple was split from top to bottom. Jesus had paid for our sins. But the story doesn't end there. The story doesn't end in Jesus' death. There was a man there who was a soldier, and he said, surely this is the Son of God. But it doesn't even end there. Where does it end? It doesn't. You see, the next thing in the story is that Jesus, 3 days later, came back to life. You see, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came 3 days later to visit Jesus in the tomb, but instead they saw an angel, and his garments were white as snow, and there were guards there, and they could not answer. They were just so amazed. So what happened? The Mary and the other Mary came up to the angel and they said, where is Jesus? And the angel said, Jesus is alive. So they ran to go tell the disciples. But before they could do that, they met Jesus. Jesus encountered them and said, tell my disciples that I'm alive and to meet me in Galilee. And that's where they met. And over 500 people saw the resurrected Jesus. And then before he went into heaven, he told us to tell everyone we know that Jesus is alive and that he has paid for our sins if we follow him. But just so that we know that I'm not making this up, let's look to our Bibles. We're going to be in 1 Corinthians 15, which is a great Easter text. I hope that you guys already have your Bibles with you. I've got mine right here. So I'm going to open it up and I'm going to be in verse 3. And I'm going to read down to verse 6. So 1 Corinthians 15, verses 3 through 6, it says this. I hope that you're following along. For I delivered to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers at one time, most of whom are still alive. Wow. You see, we need to find our identity in Christ because he has lived the perfect life for us. He has died our death for us, but he cannot be held back by the grave. And after 3 days, he came back to life. He was on the earth for another 40 days before he went into heaven. And one day he will come back and he will make the world perfect. He will make this kingdom fully on earth. He will have a city that we all live in. We will all live in the New Jerusalem together underneath the rule of sweet King Jesus. So today I have a challenge for you. If you have never considered following Jesus, I would say today is the day to do it. If you have never considered having Jesus to be your Lord and Savior, not just believing that Jesus exists, but saying that Jesus is the King of my life. If you have never done that, today I challenge you. Find your identity in Christ. Now, superheroes have identities and they've got alter egos, but today I want you to find your identity in the only superhero that you will ever need, Jesus, who is the greatest, strongest King that we will ever know. So today on Easter, or Easter week, I want you guys to know that Jesus loves you, that he died for you, and that he is calling you to repent of your sins and to believe in him. Again, my name is Pastor Campbell. I'm so excited that I've been able to share this message with you guys. I hope that you guys have a great week.
Hey guys, let's pause for just a moment and go to the Lord in prayer. What a happy Easter week it has been. It's been different, but it is a happy Easter week. He is risen. He is risen indeed. One thing that I would encourage you guys to pray for right now while you're sitting around the table or maybe hanging out by the TV is to pray for some of your friends. Pray for your friends that in school, maybe you haven't talked to or seen in a while. Pray for some of your friends from Sunday school or from Awana. And maybe pray for some of those kids that maybe live down the street from you or maybe that are on your ball team. Be thinking about the friends that you know who maybe don't know about Jesus. Or maybe they've not heard that Jesus is alive. So let's take a moment and pray for our friends. God, thank you that we can come today and celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. There is no more important event that has ever happened on this earth, and we are thankful that Jesus died, that he was buried, and that he's alive. And so, God, we worship you and thank you for that today. God, for our friends, God, maybe we haven't seen them in a while. I pray that you would continue to protect them, that you would help them as they're doing their schoolwork, that you would help them to respect and obey their parents. God, help us to do that as well. And ultimately, God, I pray that you would use us so that we can tell our friends about the gospel. Maybe our friends at church, or maybe our friends from school, or right down the street or next door. God, I pray that we would be a good friend and a good neighbor so that we can share the love of Jesus with them. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for our sins. But thank you that you brought him back to life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Have a great night.